joining us for more on this story is Jason Calacanis, the CEO of Inside.com, and Mark Grossman. He's here at Set with us, and he's president of Bold Streak and a technology lawyer. So welcome to you both. Look, Jason, I know you're no fan of Facebook. So, you know, does this, but how do you react to this information? I mean, is this to you more about Cambridge Analytica? Is it more, speak more to the problems that Facebook has, or is it that big of a deal at all?
Yeah, thanks for having me. It's a huge deal, and I think that we've moved from an existential crisis for Facebook to an actual crisis. Obviously, Facebook is known, Zuckerberg himself, for moving fast and breaking things, and I don't think they ever considered the downside, and obviously it's been a great stock to own because they don't care what breaks. Now we're finding out that what might be breaking is democracy and our country and our ability to relate with each other as Americans, and this is extremely dangerous. For Facebook, obviously you mentioned regulation as a possible issue, and maybe consumers backing off. I doubt that. But there are other issues, like the ability to buy companies. I don't think that Facebook would be allowed to buy Instagram, WhatsApp, or Oculus at this moment in time. Also, the talent wars. People don't want to go work for a company like Facebook that people perceive is destroying society. And I think it's time for maybe thinking about somebody,
Jason,
stepping
this may
up
be
and taking
sort of splitting,
Zuckerberg's slot.
Splitting the hair a little too much. And we can go back to what you just said about whether someone else should be leading them. But disrupting society is the big accusation going back to the elections. And invading privacy is perhaps a different matter. And that seems to be more what this current episode is about. So do you think that users are more likely to react to this idea that their information has been shared against their liking, or do you think it's a more important to them that Facebook seems to be playing a positive role?
Yeah, I think consumers love the product. They love Instagram. It's very hard to get off the addiction of social media. So I don't think that consumers are going to flee these products tomorrow. They're pretty ingrained. It is a great opportunity for an entrepreneur to come in and maybe create a competitor to these products. But I think at this point, if you look at Zuckerberg, he's MIA. When was the last time we heard Zuckerberg talk about this? It's a complete and utter failure of leadership. And I actually think that you don't want to own the stock Facebook. And I think I'm going to officially take them out of the FANG today. I'm going to replace them with a D, and we're going to call it the DANG. We're going to put Disney in there going forward. I think Sheryl Sandberg should run the company. Honestly, she's a better communicator. She's better at understanding how to manage these issues. Actually, she run Facebook, but hey, that wouldn't be a bad call either. I think she's a tremendous leader, and Zuckerberg has done a horrible, horrible job, handling this crisis. Mm-hmm. He's done an amazing job being a pirate.
Mark, what's your reaction, your position as a technology lawyer? What do you think Facebook has or hasn't done wrong here, and your reaction to some of the things Jason just said?
They've done everything wrong, but I don't think any of it matters. They followed corporate best practices. They had an agreement that said you won't do certain things with the data. They had an agreement that said you'll self-certify data destruction. None of that happened. And within the corporate world, that's almost normal. No, it is normal that nothing happened. Now, the latest is there's going to be an audit of this data. That's new. That's unusual. And I think it's only happening now because of the horrific bad press that Facebook is getting. Otherwise, this would continue to be swept under the carpet.
And so what's the consequence going to be? Is this now crossed enough of a line that we'll see regulation from the government that'll clamp down on all of these stocks moving forward or not?
Not in this environment as it is in the United States. In a Trump world where everything is about deregulation, no matter how bad this is, and this is bad, I don't realistically
think everything in Trump world's about deregulation, with the biggest media merger potentially being halted this week.
Well, we look at all the regulations coming off the books right now. We look at issues like gun control where nothing happens. I think this is another issue where there's going to be a lot of talk, short memory, short news cycle, and the world moves along.
Fair enough. By the way, Jason, I wanted you to hear what Jim Cramer had to say earlier, kind of to the point analyst Jason Ware was just making, too, about this not disrupting Facebook's business model. Take a listen.
Let's just go over the numbers do matter. Revenue's up 47%. Earnings per share up 57%. It's become a pariah. Does it deserve to be a pariah? Does it have other levers that it can pull? Are these people, frankly, just tone deaf? I think the people who are genuinely surprised, Wolf, that this stock could be down this much on a news story about some names that they may have shared or may not have shared with Russians that was from an outfit that was connected to Trump. It's like, wow, okay, this is like the Russian probe. Could you give me something that hurts? What does it have to do with the price earnings of Facebook?
That was when the shares were down less than 5%
right.
as well. Jason, yeah. They're now down about 7%. So is it that the regulatory risk is just bigger than Jim or others were citing at the time? Or why do you think the reaction has been so outsized?
Yeah, I think people have watched this story get worse and worse and worse. And I think that we're going to see a couple of more cards turn over that are very bad for Facebook. And I think the reason why Facebook is not suing the company in question, Cambridge Analytica, is because they don't want to go into that discovery process. And the last couple of times, you know, they've done discovery of Facebook's misdoings, it's been pretty ugly. Obviously, their face,
but Mark,
they got the largest
Mark,
fine
point, not,
in history
for
this.
It's not clear that Cambridge Analytica did anything wrong. What would Facebook be suing them for?
Well, they're probably in breach of contract. But as far as discovery, that's a minor issue here. They're going to have congressional investigations. They're going to have parliamentary investigations. The only reason they haven't sued them is it's too soon.
This is part of Facebook's business model. A couple of years ago, it opened up the ability to access this personal data to these third-party developers.
And that's why nothing is going to change. Regulation, I don't expect it in the United States. Yes, there'll be more in the EU. Yes, there'll be more fines in the EU. But this is core. This is cost-benefit analysis. Pay the fines and continue with the business model.
But the EU wants to push back on this big time. 26% of market cap, the S&P 500, is tech. In the EU, it's about 4 or 5%. They've got nothing to lose now than to go after these sorts of companies, and there's a political backing to do it now as well.
It's a bigger slap on the wrist. I'm not buying in. When you look at Equifax and how bad that was worse information that was actually meant to be kept secret. And what happened to Equifax in the days since Equifax? Nothing. Yeah. Do you really think Facebook, when everything is supposed to be public-facing, or almost everything is supposed to be public-facing, is really going to tank over this issue? I don't think so.
Okay. Mark, thank you for joining us. Jason, also thank you very much for joining us.
My pleasure.